Hello my little butterflies, in this video is gonna be my belated birthday haul and a little library haul that I have. So y'all, my birthday was July 21st and I turned 21 on the 21st. So it was like my golden birthday. I'm tight, right? I know. I had a blast. I loved my 21st birthday so much. My sister had Khalil for the whole weekend, so I had fun. I acquired 5 books for my birthday, and I'm gonna do my birthday haul before I do my library haul, because my library haul is only 3 books and they're all in the same series. I just wanted to talk about them. And so yeah, let's start off with my first book, which is the last book that I got for my birthday. So it's where the last is first, whatever. The first book that I got for my birthday is Milk and Honey by Rupi. I don't know how to say the name, y'all know. It's all over BookTube, I don't know how to say the name. So what drove me to get this book, I was in Walmart. So this is for my birthday. My fiance bought this because I made him buy it for my birthday. And I started to read it standing in the line in Walmart. I read the first poem and then I got to the second page and I saw this and I was like, I gotta buy it because this gotta be good. And I didn't, they got all these graphics in here and illustrations in here, and I just think that's awesome for a book of poetry. So, I mean, this is all over BookTube, and I've been hearing about it. I wanted to read it. Don't get me wrong, I didn't want to read it. I wanted to read it, but I wasn't in a rush to get it. You know how you want to read books, but you're not really in a rush to get it. You want to get other stuff first. That's how I felt about this until I saw it and I started reading. I was like, you buying this? This is for my birthday. And he hard up thought he was not buying this book. He thought wrong. The rest of these books were off my Amazon wish list. So the second book that I got for my birthday is called Blackbird Fly by Erin Entrada Kelly. And this is a middle grade novel. And to be honest, the whole reason that this, well, I did hear about it on BookTube, but the whole reason that this was even on my wish list was because it's in Louisiana. It's in Chapel Spring, Louisiana. Don't ask me if that's a real place. It might be, like, it might not. I don't know. I don't know everywhere. I don't know all the places in Louisiana, but this book is based in Louisiana, so that's really why, the main reason why I wanted to read this book. So basically, this book follows this girl, Apple. Don't ask me to pronounce her last name because I can't. But it's about this girl named Apple, and she's basically an outcast in her school. She believes there are at least three interesting facts about a person, and the 3 interesting facts about her make her an outcast. So it's basically about her little high school drama, about her, well, middle school drama. It's about her middle school drama and her finding herself to be okay with being an outcast, because she gets 2 unsuspecting friends that helped her to see that it's okay to be different. You don't have to be accepted by everyone. It's okay to be you. So this is, I don't know if you would call it a coming of age novel, but it is a very getting comfortable with yourself novel, like being happy with yourself. Because I know everybody goes through this in high school where you feel unsure of yourself, high school, middle school, whatever. You feel unsure of yourself at some point that you have to feel like you need to be accepted by everyone else. And everyone goes through that stage, and that's okay, as long as you realize in the end that you don't need to be like everyone else. The next book that I got for my birthday is The Land of Forgotten Girls by Erin Entrada Kelly. So I should have done both together, but they're by the same author. So this book, I didn't hear about it on BookTube, but it was, you know, when you put something in like your wish list on Amazon to give you suggested books. And I thought this sounded really cool. I think this is also set in Louisiana, so it's another reason why I put it on my list. But I think this girl, I think her name is Soledad. I don't know how to pronounce her name, so we're just gonna call her S. So S, I think, is adopted, and she's from the Philippines, but she moved to Louisiana, and it's about her, you know, I guess, accepting what happened to her past life in the Philippines, that something that happened to Amelia was her fault. I don't know who Amelia is, but it happened, it was her fault, and she keeps saying that Louisiana would never be the same as the Philippines, so it's about her fitting into her new life, getting used to her new life, new people, and I guess just moving on from her past, pretty much. And that is what this book is about. This is also a middle grade novel. So I have 2 middle grade novels, because I do want to start reading more middle grade novels, because they seem very fun and quick. The next book that I have is The Scarlet Thread by D.S. Murphy. I don't remember how I heard about this book, but the reason I got this book, and it sounds so good. Basically, it's about this girl named Cadence Monroe. When she touches people, she can see how you die. think she can see when, but I know for sure she can see how you die. After she saw how her little brother was going to die and she did nothing to stop it, her parents abandoned her in a juvenile detention facility. So she went through this period where she wouldn't touch anyone. She didn't want to talk to anyone because of it, which I think is fucked up that they did that to her. Because that's, I mean, what is she going to do? Right before she turned 18, she got a visit from this cute guy, you know, that, you know, she wanted to pour her heart out to. And he tricked her into spilling all of her secrets to him. And she thought that, because he told her that she was really special. And apparently, he was the only one looking for her. This power that she has is something that people want. And she barely escaped with her life. So she ends up in this like mansion learning how to control her abilities. So yeah, doesn't that sound amazing? You can touch somebody and see how they die. That sounds great. I mean, that's not a power I would want to have because that's a lot of responsibility I don't want. But doesn't that sound amazing? It's going pour down tonight. It's been nasty like this all day, y'all. Like, it's been raining all day and it was sunny for a minute. That's why I decided to sit down and film. And it looks terrible outside. Like, it looks like it's gonna be so bad tonight. Like, it's gonna be terrible. Okay, I need to get through this video. Let me turn the light on because I feel like it got dark. Sorry, y'all. We got the roll with this. I turn the light on and it looks just golden right here. But this is it. This is it. And then I'm gonna just run through my series for that I got from the library. The last book that I got for my birthday is called Beyond the Bright Light by Lauren Wolk. And this one, I believe I heard about this through BookTube. So basically, this book is about this girl. She's trapped on an island. Well, basically, she was put in a boat and sent away as a baby. Somebody on the island saved her and took care of her and raised her. And she's living on the island. And she sees this fire across the island and another island across from her. And she doesn't. And she it makes her start to wonder about what they have left. What they have other in other. What else they have in the world? How big the world is other than the island that she is and the person she sees every day. And it's, I believe this is a middle grade novel too. I'm pretty sure this is a middle grade novel too. So I have three middle grade novels that I'm definitely gonna be reading to get me through the hard times when I start to slow down and get, like, you know, get fed up and behind with reading books or whatever. When I just go through a book that's just so bad, I just need something to, you know, uplift me and push me through something quick. That's what I'm going to be reading. So these are my books that I got for my birthday. Boom.
And boom goes the dynamite.
So now on to my library haul, which is all one series. So I won't talk about all of them because I don't know all of them. I only know about the first one, which I've read before, and that is the Nevermore series by Kelly Craig. Nevermore, which is book one, and Shadowed, which is book two, and the Oblivion, which is book three. So basically, about this before. I've talked about Nevermore before. I always say this is an amazing book. I read this book years ago. I want to say I was in middle school when I read this. I'm not 100% sure. That's why I just got the whole series to reread it again. To reread the first book again, because I only read the first book. I didn't read two and three before. I just got the first book. You're basically following these two teenagers through Edgar Allan Poe's poems. Like, it's not a retelling. They're literally, like, if you were to drop into a book, they are literally in his poems, okay? But it's like some creepy shit happening. So, like, it's, I know this is not the best. This is not at all the best description in the book. But it's a better description if you ask me. You are living in Edgar Allan Poe's poems. Like, they have, like, a regular world they live in, but some creepy shit happens and they end up living in the world Edgar Allan Poe's poem, like, through different poems. And it is crazy, y'all. Like, it's some creepy crap happening. And that's why I got this again to reread it. Because I need a refresher before I continue on with the series. Just to refresh my mind and everything. So I've got the whole series. Because I'm going to read this whole series. Because I've been talking about it and I never went back to finish the series. So it's like a, it's kind of like a gothic kind of thing going on in this book. And it sounds amazing. Like, it is amazing. Like, this book, I remember this book is great. I mean, I hope my perspective don't change on it since I was younger when I read it than what I was now. But I really enjoyed this book when I did read it. So I got the whole freaking trilogy that I'm gonna read finally. I don't know why I didn't do this before at the library. So I can't wait to read these, and I'm gonna finish reading this after I'm done with my TBR that I had for August, which I did my July and my August one together. So after I'm done reading those books, I'm gonna jump into these. So I heard and got them, cause I doubt people was taking them, but you never know. So I'm being selfish and I'm hogging. So guys, that is all the books I talked about in this video. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.